Good morning, all of you. Welcome to this e-class. Yesterday we have already learned about the importance and need of lesson plan. Today's topic is characteristics of a good lesson plan. We have already learned that what is the importance, what are the needs that a lesson plan, importance and needs of lesson plan. So today we will know about the characteristics which in a good lesson plan we have to include. Okay, so let's start with our class today. Lesson plan should be in a written form. The lesson plan, if you want a good lesson plan, it should be in a written form. That means you will have to write the plan of a lesson. Next, a good lesson plan should be based on principle of teaching and teaching method. I forgot to put the line over here. You can put it. Teaching and teaching method. That means a good lesson plan should be based on principle of teaching and teaching methods. That means it should be mentioned. The good teaching method should be there, written in that lesson plan, and it should be based on the principle of teaching and teaching methods. Whatever methods a student teacher or pupil teacher or the teacher is using while teaching this lesson, they should mention it, mention the teaching and teaching methods in their lesson plan. Next, must follow a standardized format. I have told you all earlier also that when you are writing the lesson plan, you have a format, and that format should be standardized. That means a well standardized format should be there for the lesson plan. Next, must give general and specific objective separately. When you are writing a lesson plan, the general objectives and the general objective and the specific objectives should be written separately. That means you will have to mention that what are the general objectives which the this lesson is giving to the students, and the specific objectives also which as a teacher you will try to give to the students. So it should be written separately. Next, description of audio visual aid should be there in lesson plan. It should be mentioned that the audio visual aid, if you are using it as a teaching aid, you should mention it in your lesson plan that you are using this audio visual aid in your as aids in your lesson plan too. Next, important examples should be included in a good lesson plan. When you are giving some example, good examples in front of the students in class, you should mention that example, include that example in your lesson plan, so that it makes more clear to your lesson. Good lesson plan, include it will be called a good lesson plan if you include the good examples or the important example. If you put in that lesson plan, it will be clear to you and the person who is looking at your lesson plan, and whatever you are teaching in the class, it will be shown in that, mentioned in that lesson plan. Next, subject, time, class, period, average age of the students should be mentioned in the lesson plan. In a good lesson plan, subject, time, class, period, and average age of the students should be mentioned, so that a particular person knows that in which class you are teaching, which subject you are teaching, which in which time you are teaching, and which period you are teaching. At a glance, a person can look through that lesson plan. Next, summary of lesson may also be given in a good lesson plan. If you are teaching this a plan, you should summarize it before leaving the class. So, if you are writing a lesson plan, you should mention the summary also in that plan to summarize the lesson. You should mention it in the lesson plan also. So summary is also very important in this lesson plan. It makes a good lesson plan. Whenever a teacher sees that lesson plan, can rectify that what are the things you are going to teach in that lesson. I think today's class is very clear to you all. Thank you everyone. If it is if you are having any doubt, you can ask me in the class. I'll definitely solve your doubts in the class. Thank you.